The corona scourge is something which will never let life be the same again when we recover from it. But every tragedy has lesson curves in it. As far as the judiciary is concerned, I think we have moved in the right direction. We have moved rapidly to virtual courts, virtual arguing, virtual interaction, client, lawyer, judge. But in a practical level, this has remained and remains today theory. We need to operationalize it in practice much more. Today, the courts are functioning at less than vacation court capacity. The Supreme Court has roughly 10, 12, 15 cases every other day. Moreover, the hearings are not geared to be final hearings or even semi-final hearings. They are very short, perfunctory issues. I think we need to institutionalize it even during COVID. Why is it not possible to have longer hearings? We need to ramp up the capacity to at least 5 courts, if not 8 courts, with 10, 20 cases each. Because after all, the healing touch is out there is required not only by the coronavirus afflicted person, but by the litigant who comes in pain. Also, our courts are not the same everywhere. There are many Indias within one. The Supreme Court and even the Delhi High Court may be far apart from large part of the Mufassil courts, the civil courts, the lower structure, and indeed high courts in other states. We need to make it a national grid paradigm, which is the same for the country. And therefore, from that we go to what would be, in fact, possibly the new normal, one of the unintended beneficial side effects of COVID, namely that post-COVID, we will do more and more of virtual lawyering, virtual litigation. And that should be our object. For that, we need to ramp up capacities, increase internet connectivity humongously, quake court connections. The other day, for example, with all the good intentions, the Supreme Court app malfunctioned, even though the workload was infinitesimal. So we are now talking of all India normal. So it's not enough to issue directions, which is a good move. It's not enough to express the hope. It is important to ramp up capacity and implement. I think lawyering will change for the better. The orality of the process will go or reduce significantly. There'll be no concept of things like outstation and instation. Written briefs will become more and more important. Precision, time limits, things which we've been trying for decades may well happen as an indirect long-term effect of COVID. Ultimately, court shifts, courts sitting in different shifts could be a new normal because there is no time element in virtual lawyering. And as in Singapore, you might be able to buy time for the rich litigant who can afford to pay, and that money is used for court infrastructure. Lastly, on a personal level, to everyone, why only young lawyers? I think this is the time for introspection. It is the time when we must remember why rapacious attacks on Mother Earth have their own vendetta. And I think it is the time when we read, we write, develop at least one or two alternative talents and interests, remain optimistic, take care of your health, and develop above all an attitude of gratitude for what you have. Thank you.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel and click the bell icon.